This video is going to deal with isolation and growth of microorganisms in the laboratory. We're going to look at a method of isolation called the streak plate. The streak plate is extremely important because whenever we deal with bacteria or other microorganisms, we always end up with something that looks like this in the beginning. We need to know which microorganism we're dealing with. So we've got to be able to isolate something out of this and make something useful. We are going to deal with a couple of concepts. The ideal thing is to have a culture with one and only one species of bacteria present. That allows us to study the characteristics. We may be looking at the cause of disease. We may be looking at the right culture to process some food or drink product. And there's a lot of different other reasons why we want to have one and only one bacteria in the plate. We talk about colonies, and a colony is basically grown from a single bacterial cell. When you look at that plate, there are a lot of different colonies. We might deal with a pure culture, and a pure culture is obtained by transferring something from that original colony that started from a single colony-forming unit to a new sterile medium using aseptic technique, which basically is going to prevent any form of contamination. When we deal with the quadrant streak, basically it is going to dilute the sample until we have individual bacterial cells or colony-forming units. These are allowed to grow into individual colonies. Therefore, our purpose is to obtain individual colonies. And when we say dilute, we're going to decrease the number of cells in a sample being spread out from one set of streaks to another. When we deal with the quadrant streak method, cells from these individual colonies may be transferred to a new sterile media for the development of pure cultures, which we can then use. Here's your procedure. We start out with a petri dish. You're going to mark where you're going to start your streak, flame your loop before you take your sample. You're then going to touch the original sample culture only once. Try not to bring too much media into it, because if you bring too much material into it, it's just going to make it more difficult to do a streak plate. You're going to streak the plate beginning at the mark, which means you're going to touch down and you're going to go like that, and you're going to go back and forth several times in order to be able to spread that material out. Next, you're going to flame again. When you flame again, it's going to destroy all of the bacteria on the loop. Do not go back and pick up new material. You take your cool loop over, you're going to rotate your plate slightly, and you're going to put the streaks in going like this. Notice they do not cross over everywhere. They've got a couple of little bits of cross, but not a tremendous amount. That's going to help dilute things out because you're only spreading the bacteria from the places where it crossed. Then you're going to go back and you're going to flame again. You're going to put in a new set of streaks and go back and flame again. And now you're going to put in another set of streaks. What you're doing is every time you're diluting it, because you're spreading this material out, you're only picking up where you get the intersection. A very simple process. You label it. You're going to put your name, your seat, your class, your date. You're going to seal it with a strip of parafilm. You're going to incubate it inverted in the incubator. And we do it inverted so that we don't get accumulation of moisture in the petri dish. If you did it right, next time you look at it, it's going to look like this. You can see very distinctive individual little colonies. You've got some colonies that are so separated away that you can easily take that particular colony out, or a little bit of it, and then you will have basically what we call a pure culture.